Hello friends, today we will start about Containverse 2020 introduction. In this video, we will just browsing all the menu and options in the Containverse. So we will little bit familiar with all the options, and later on we can check each and every single option in detail. The Containverse, this is a version is 2020. You can see over here. This is the Containverse desktop client 2020, and this is a document management software. There are many DMS application which is available in the market, but why Containverse? Because of its flexibility and simplicity. So we will start with the option with the file. Here you can see the all menu, file menu, home, view, tools, window, help. So in the file menu, you can see the option which is document. From here, you can upload the document like a scan for the. You can choose the scanner. You can set a scanner. Here are the options, and here are the Containverse help. You can see over the recent document which is created in the Containverse. You can directly open document from here also. You can see in the home menu. In home menu, you can see a full screen window. Find, quick find. Accept and reject document, landscape and portrait view, and summary of the document, like that. In a view, also you can lock and unlock the document. You can hide the status bar. You can hide the navigation document, properties, to-do list. Instead of using this, you can directly hide from the shortcuts. I will show you how it is. If you want to hide the properties, to-do list, document list, you can hide. Just click on here. See, auto hide. So you get a larger view for your document. If you want to bring back, just click on that. Like this. In window menu, you can see the, if you open multiple documents, you can view the in the cascade tile window like that. And help is all about the Containverse help. Even from here, you can take online support. Within a few minutes, you will get revert. They will revert you. They have excellent support team. Before I go to the navigator menu, I will show you one PowerPoint presentation. And after that, simultaneously, I will show you in navigator menu that how we can use to all the options. So in the PowerPoint presentation, you can see the one picture, which is a warehouse picture. So this warehouse is located somewhere. So it's we can, it is physically present over there. So we can call with their address, like this is a Mumbai warehouse, this is a Bangalore warehouse. So in this system, we can give this name is WW Cloudwell warehouse. Okay, so and in this warehouse, you can find the cabinets. So in the cabinets, we can give a name, finance RD. Likewise, you can see a different cabinet, like in the purchase, or you can say purchase cabinets, you can say maintenance documents cabinets, and finance cabinet. So here we can see the finance cabinet, and we can call them finance underscore RD. In that cabinet, you can find a drawers. So like in finance cabinet, you can find accounts drawers. So in these drawers, you can see, I can see here two drawers. One is payment and second one is invoice. Here in this first drawer, I will keep all the invoice files, and in this second drawer, I will keep all the payments related files. So we can keep these files in one folder. Like, see, there are the folders. And one more thing I just want to mention you that if suppose in this drawer, you can see there are two segments. So one is payable and second is receivable. So there are the subfolders in the payment folder, which is payable and receivable. So likewise, now we will see this in Containverse. Here you can see This is the icon is look like a warehouse icon, and this is my WW Cloud well, as you can see in the pictures. In that there is a cabinet which is finance RD. This is my cabinet, and in that cabinet you can find a drawers. So this is my account drawers. In that account drawers you can find invoice and payments, these two folders. And as I told you that in payments we find two subfolder, which is payable and receivable. So it's the same in real life how we work, the same we work in ContentWorks. So this is our navigator menu, and as I told you earlier, the ContentWorks is known for the simplicity. So you now will understand how simple it is. Now we will check input tray. See input tray. Here also I will show you one small PPT before we can check all input tray menu. Input tray is all about upload the documents in the ContentWorks through different medium. Like this is the printer. From the help of the printer you can upload the document. Like the scan, you can scan multiple copies at the same time and upload the document in the ContentWorks. You can upload a folder like browsing a folder through PC. Even Microsoft Office integration is also available there. You can directly take a document from Microsoft Word, Excel, PPT. And here you can see all these options is like that, which I explained you, the scan, Microsoft Office, global, which is for folder, upload, and printer, all input tray is there. And the third option is documents, document menu. In this menu you can see the list of the documents, like where is my, okay, I will show you. See, there are two company, XYZ company and ABC. This it will show the type, which type of his document, and who is the creator of this document. Created date it will show, modified date it will show, how many pages it will contain it will show in this, comments if any for the document, and references also you can see if his reference is available. Here are versioning. Versioning is of what, like if I make a changes in this document, it will reflect, it will show the two versions of this file. One is without the original one, and second one what we, you know, make a changes in that. We will check all this thing in later. This is a to-do's list. To-do list, it's all about, you know, it show you, it will if something is pending task is remaining, something assigned a task to you, it will show you in this to-do list. We will also check all this stuff later. And properties is this, like that, this is the metadata of this file. In this metadata you will get information like a date, invoice number, party name. And why this metadata is so much important, because help of this metadata you can find any document within a second. So this metadata is very much important. Same like here also, as comments, if any comments for the, of that document you can see over there. General is all information about, you know, the file size, the location of the folder, where it is the file is located, like this is the finance RD accounts invoice, where it is located, and references. We can check any references over there. So this is all about in this introduction video. In the next video we will check each and every single option in detail. Thank you.